yesterday we had seen what we have seen, the first orientation video I have shown you, correct? That was given to you while choosing the elective, correct? That was given to you. So that again I showed you, in that we have seen about this syllabus and how the marks distribution is there for EM. It's like the same that you had in the semester 7 for ILE, the same way you have for this semester also, that is internal assessment and the exam of 80 marks, correct? And then we had seen few things about environmental management, then environmental management system kya hai, ISO 14001, just brief things we have seen about the certain topics, right? Environmental policy, then environmental management, mein kya kya steps aate hai, what is the significance of environmental management, all those things we had seen in the yesterday's lecture, just briefing out, okay? So we have started with this presentation also, where we had seen about concept of sustainable development. When we talk about environmental management, how sustainable development plays role. Of course, they both are like linked to each other, correct? Because when you talk about sustainable development, it is development taking into consideration all the other things. Like here, it is given environment, society, economy, all things when you take into consideration and do some benefit to the society, then it's called the sustainable development. Right? Then we had seen what does environmental management, when we say, what does it involve? It actually involves everything that is present in the environment, everything. Then, this characteristics, concept of environmental management, some definitions of environmental management that are given by few different researchers that we had seen. Then significance of environmental management, that also we had seen. General scheme, what is to be followed when you talk about environmental management, what are the steps that are followed? In because this environmental management, you could see it is followed in organizations, in various industries, companies, institutions, okay, wherein whatever product they are making, whatever process it is going on in a particular say a company, so how it is going to hamper the environment, and for that you require this environmental management in those areas. We were here, that is trends in environmental management, okay, that we had seen, and we were with the initiatives. Yesterday we had stopped with the environmental initiatives in India. Few of the environmental initiatives in India we had seen, that is how the Ministry of Environment and Forest came into being. Okay, then you have certain pollution control boards, that is central pollution control boards, you have state pollution control boards. Okay, so that things, that is the environmental action program. These are few things. Now, till now, there are various initiatives, there are various rules, there are various laws related to environment management. Okay, so till this, we had seen in the yesterday's lecture. Okay, there is environmental initiatives in India that we had seen. Then, like when we talk about environmental issues, initiatives in India, similarly at global level also, there are initiatives taken in relation to environment management. So, ISO 14000 EMS certification. The international environmental standards are intended to provide organizations with the elements of an effective environmental system, which can be integrated with other management requirements to assist organizations to achieve an environment management system to support it to cover the following major areas. Actually, EMS, they said last previous lecture mein bataya tha, ISO 14000 EMS certification is ISO 14001. These are standards that are need to be followed when you talk about environmental management system. Okay, so in compliance with the standards, then you get this ISO 14000 certification. Okay, it includes major areas, that is environment management system, environmental auditing, environmental labeling, environmental performance evaluation, and life cycle assessment. ISO 14000 builds a single global management system that allows effective management of environmental responsibilities, liabilities, cost, document commitment to governmental management system. Governmental environmental, sorry, यहाँ पे environmental manager है, तो commitment to environmental management system. Then ISO 14000 is a way of empowering business to take control of environmental responsibility and encouraging government departments to approach the challenge with far greater flexibility. It does not only relate to massive global companies. Okay, so standard states, it has been written to be applicable to all types, sizes of organizations, all types and sizes of organizations, and to accommodate diverse geographical, cultural, and social conditions. ISO 14001 certification is an initiative to bring about uniformity in environmental compliance standard to reduce the impediments to trade among the countries. Now, इसके बारे में दैट इज 14000 पहले था एंड देन यू हैड दिस 14001 सर्टिफिकेशन. ओके, यू हैव अ कंप्लीट मॉड्यूल ऑन आईएसओ सर्टिफिकेशन. सो इन दैट वी विल स्टडी व्हाट इज आईएसओ सर्टिफिकेशन. व्हेन यू टॉक अबाउट स्टैंडर्ड्स, तो उसमें क्या क्या एरियाज कवर करता है आईएसओ 14001, हाउ इज द ऑडिटिंग, एनवायरमेंटल ऑडिटिंग डन व्हेन द सर्टिफिकेशन इज टू बी गिवन. Okay, so all those things we will be looking forward in the further module of ISO 14001 EMS certification. You have a whole module on that. Okay. Okay, ISO 14001 certification is an initiative to bring about uniformity in environmental compliance standards to reduce the impediments to trade among the countries. If it is accepted and implemented properly, it can bring about a lot of changes in the present Indian scenario. After the increase of environmental standards around the world, ISO assess the need for international environmental standard. They formed the Strategic Advisory Group on Environment, that is SAGE, in 1991 to consider whether such standards could serve to be effective instruments of pollution control. So a set of international standards which bring worldwide focus on environment encourage a cleaner, safer, healthier world for all of us. The existence of these standards allow organizations to focus their environment on the basis of internationally accepted criteria. At present, many countries and regional groupings are generating their own requirement for environmental issues, and these vary between the groups. A single standard will ensure that there are no conflicts between the regional interpretations of good environmental practice. Correct. When you talk about good environmental practice, every organization, every person, every individual will have their own view. Correct. There will not be a common policy that will be followed, and that is why the standards are there. So that commonly, when you talk about reducing the impact on the environment, okay, so what it actually means, what it technically means, okay, so that's global, I mean, all over the policy needs to be same, and for that you have a set of standards. So when you talk about EM, that is environment management, all these things, so you also have certain things, that is, when you talk about mostly energy efficiency, so LEED, that is Leadership in Energy and Environment Design, which came into being in 1994. So it is a set of rating system for the design, construction, operation, and maintenance of green buildings, homes, neighborhood, developed by US Green Building Council. LEED is intended to help building owners and operators to be environmentally responsible and use resources efficiently. Now, बहुत जगह जैसे यहाँ पे लिखा है that it currently this currently consists of the green building design and construction, green interior design and construction, green building operation and maintenance, and green neighborhood development. Basically, when you talk about green building or energy efficient building, jab hum log bolte hain, so this LEED, okay, so this LEED, that is Leadership in Energy and Environmental Design, so they have certain procedures that your criteria must meet. Okay, there are certain, when you talk about energy efficiency, so LEED has certain criteria that are to be met when you talk about construction of a green building or the energy efficient building. So just given an example, that also becomes a part of environment management. United Nations Environmental Programme. This is also an agency of the United Nations that coordinates its environmental activities, assisting developing countries in implementing environmentally sound policies and practices. It was found as a result of the United Nations Conference on the Human Environment in June 1972. Its activities cover a wide range of issues regarding the atmosphere, marine and terrestrial ecosystem, environmental governance, and green economy. It has played a significant role in developing international environmental conventions, promoting environmental science and information, and illustrating the way those can be implemented in conjunction with policy, working on the development and implementation of policy with national governments, regional institutions in conjunction with the environmental non-government organizations. Actually, this United Nations Environmental Program, this is also a global initiative. Okay, just to make sure, okay, that all the environmental activities that are carried out, okay, so they are properly implemented globally, okay. And UNEP, that is this United Nations Environmental Program, has also been active in funding and implementing environment-related development projects. Then, you have the Indian Green Building Council. So it was formed by Co-Federation of Indian Industry in the year 2001 and is continuously striving towards wider adoption of eco-friendly or green building concept in the Indian industry. There are three primary ranking in India. Okay, so these are GRIHA and IGBC, etc. Now these are the ranking in India. Okay, so you have one more topic of green initiatives. Okay, in that I will tell you what are these rankings, which promotes a whole building approach to sustainability based on the principle of five elements of the nature. That is, when you talk about green building initiative, what are the five elements that are you need to, you know, take into mind? That is sustainable site development, water savings, material selection, energy efficiency, and indoor environmental quality. Green building, that is green or sustainable building, is the practice of creating healthier and more resource efficient models of construction, renovation, operation, maintenance, and demolition. So that is about your green building, correct? Okay, so when you talk about green building, it is reduce the amount of, when you talk about the construction, that is reduce the amount of waste generated at a construction site. When you talk about the design, it is the building design details that will help to reduce the construction materials and energy or water requirements when completed. When you talk about the material selection, it is the careful selection of the construction materials that will leave less of an environmental impact. And when you talk about the goal of the green building, it is the reduce, reuse, and recycle. That is building the design based on standard sizes of materials, buy higher quality to reduce the rejects, recycle the scraps, train crew, and renovate the existing building. Okay, now, जो यहाँ पे इन्होंने दिया है, okay. Thank you. So that was basically about very brief about the green buildings. Okay, so यहाँ पे जो इसमें दिया है, it was formed in confederation of Indian industry in the year 2001. अभी जैसे green building LEED है, okay, जैसे LEED you have a certification, okay, वैसे you have this GRIHA and IGBC also. जैसे यहाँ पे लिखा है, there are three primary ranking in India. GRIHA, IGBC, etc. Primary ranking, I mean the certifications. Okay, when you talk about, jaise I'll tell you, step level by level, when you are doing any course, suppose level by level, you get certifications, right? Depending upon your performance, you get a certification, right? So likewise, these are certifications. What is this? Primary ranking is nothing but the certification. Like this GRIHA, GRIHA is nothing but the green rating for integrated habitat assessment. Okay, so that is one certification that you will get when you go into this green building concept. Okay, similarly you have this IGBC, is the Indian Green Building Council. Okay, so that is also a part of the Green Building Council only, but you get the certification from them. Okay, so this is brief about the green buildings. Okay, so just an overview for you, that is when you talk about environment management, so there are various initiatives that are taken at the global level, at the the national level, correct? So out of that, because these are not the new concepts, the LEED certification or Indian Green Building Council or this GRIHA, IGBC, these are not the old ones. These are initiatives that are being already taken. Okay, so when you talk about initiatives in environment management, so these are few of the initiatives taken. Okay. Then next we will talk about the career prospects. Okay, career when you talk about environment management, in the first module you have regarding the career opportunities in environment management. So that few things we will see. Okay, so careers in the environmental sector, it says make a difference with what you do every day. Okay. So the outline is about the green power, then why take up a green job, environment education overview, environmental career options, global trends in the corporate initiatives. Okay, so those things we will see, and some examples related to it. So when you talk about green power, so green word is perhaps one of the biggest trends to hit the modern marketplace. Yesterday also, yeah, that's the start of the lecture itself, I had told you that it's the biggest trend to hit the modern marketplace. Everywhere we turn, we are inundated with some message or story relating to green and the environment, correct? So not just our country, but globally, this green word has come a lot of in demand, correct? So that is, they have given scene, the Walmart, which is not of our country, of course. Okay, so the path towards sustainable energy sources will be long. Okay, and this is not just America that is going to follow this. This is to be followed by every country globally. Okay. They have given an example. Then, but what does it all mean? So green today means so many different things to different people. Marketing and the public relation PR departments have responded to the changing marketplace by giving everything from consumer products to automobiles a green makeover. Correct. So it's not easy being green when you talk about turning everything green. Ecosystem. Okay. Like when you talk about in relation to the ecosystem, turning everything green. Okay. So the organization, businesses, governments, and individual consumers are all struggling to adapt to a world which the planet's health and dwindling natural resources are at the center of the global conversation. The good news is that everyone seems to be trying to be some shade of green. And experimentation usually leads to innovation. So, when you talk about few simple examples of turning into green, from biogas waste to fertilizers, making carpet, manufacturing like carpet from more eco-friendly materials, reducing the food waste to environmental footprint, low-cost solutions to low-energy solutions. But at the end of the day, sustainability has become true business strategy for many organizations. So that is why we were talking about the sustainable development. Then why take a green job? Why you need to take a green job? Green, because now the first thing that we are seeing that the green world is demanding now. So when millions of everyday people will say, no, I'm not satisfied, I don't want to wait, I will not sit back, I will stand up and do something right now, right here, right in this moment. So it's when you start to make some innovations to come out differently, correct? The best way to start doing something about the environmental problem that we see around us. So when you think about going into a sector of green, so you don't have to search for problems. Look after the problems that are there nearby to you, around you. Make a positive impact in people's lives, but also become the part of 67% of environmental professionals who are highly engaged and satisfied with what they do because they see that they do make positive difference. Then levels of employee engagement, 2/3 of the environmental employees are the engaged workers. It's just that, see, this is a common general thing given for every organization, that there are people who are fully understand their responsibilities, who fully gave their effort, who are highly motivated and who really bring passion and energy to them. There are people who are less than that, there are people who are lesser than that, and then there are more lesser people that is rationally and emotionally disconnected from work and not more motivated and poor performance in the work. So there are different levels of workers in any organization. But when you see an organization which is related to environmental thing, there you will see that 2/3 of the environmental employees are engaged, completely engaged workers. So basically take this career green opportunity, green job, just because you are going to make money while doing good to the society. Work in a sector where your job is not just to develop or produce goods, but to do so efficiently, that is with minimum resources. That is called the innovation and creativity. Lastly, as we move into an era of constrained resources, organizations that help their customers minimize the waste and resource consumption will always emerge as the market leaders. So, environmental employment, employed individuals who spend 50% or more of their work time on activities associated with environmental protection, resource management, or environmental sustainability. Employment in new emerging areas among a few are alternative and renewable energy, eco-friendly and carbon management, climate change mitigation, and research organizations. So these are the emerging areas where actually you can look after the career opportunities. Then how you can change? If you are in product development, you can shape the future of the green by creating the offerings that push the definition of green to new heights. If you are into operations, you can analyze and redesign the process by which your organization does business and eliminate the waste and inefficiencies. If you are in human resources, you can push for new policies that allow employees to work virtually or new reward system that incentivize the green behaviors. Okay, so that is there are different sections in the company. So wherever you are in wherever section, okay, there you can start with some green initiatives. Lastly, well, they have seen, even if you are in the human resource department, even if you are in the HR department, you can push for new policies that allow the employees to work virtually, or new reward system can be given to incentivize the green behavior of the people who are taking the green initiatives. So environmental education overview. So environmental careers evolution. Now, environment as a formal education program has evolved over the past 4 decades. Also, now that we are studying the environmental management subject, which was not there previously, it was introduced from the last year. Correct? So that also becomes a part of the educational program. Similarly, when you talk about different fields, okay, there where environmental education has started. For example, the very, very foremost, civil engineering, where you have sanitary and public health engineering, water supply and sewage, municipal solid waste management and treatment, managing public health, all these things are covered in the civil engineering. When you talk about life sciences and chemistry, the ecology or environmental assessment, environmental sciences are covered in that field. When you talk about the architecture field, the environmental planning, environmental policy, material management, certification and sourcing, everything is actually covered in the architecture part. Similarly, when you talk about chemical engineering, pollution control and pollution prevention, clean technologies, okay, those are all things covered in chemical engineering. When you talk about the product designing, so eco-designing or designing for environment and material innovation, so those things come under the product design. When you talk about the environmental economics and environmental law and policy, so those things are, you know, come under the education program of the economics. Now, when you talk about environment management, okay, so that now we have the subject of environmental management. So implementing the environment management, business and sustainability, and environmental trade and logistics. So all those things will be covered in the environmental management field. So environmental careers categories. Okay, so you have the environment protection. You have a category of environment protection where you have air quality, water quality, site assessment and reclamation, waste management, health and safety. You have resource management as one of the category where you have energy, so energy efficiency, fisheries and wildlife, that is the biodiversity, conservation, natural resource management. So you have that one field. You have environmental sustainability field where you have education and training, research and development, policy and legislation, communication and public awareness. So all are these the categories of the environment careers. Okay. And then the environmental manager, when you talk about a person with environmental manager, okay, or who wishes to become the environmental manager, he should have the knowledge of all these fields, all these categories. So environmental careers. Currently, it is the trending jobs. They are the trending jobs. These jobs are currently in high demand in both developing and the developed countries because the problems are same globally, whether it is the developing or the developed countries. Attempting to solve the existing environmental and health problems. So you have careers in environmental impact assessment. Okay. You have environmental management system, building information, building management system. Okay. And building energy simulation or energy modeling. Okay, so there a building assessment system. So there you have the fields where you can start your environmental careers. Then also you have environment health and safety, that is EHS. Just a second. Okay. Then occupational or workplace health and safety, OHS or WHS, work health and safety, workplace health and safety. product safety, environmental economics, environmental policy planning. Okay, so there also these fields also have good opportunities, good career opportunities. Then massive investments in clean energy promise to keep farmers, urban planners, and green tech entrepreneurs in business for the next decade. So the world's first solar flight, which is the aircraft fueled completely by the electricity generated by the solar cells. So energy efficiency, they are just giving you examples to show that how energy efficiency is nowadays in such a trend. Okay. Also, the next decade environmental career, that is the farming, since sustainable agriculture requires small scale local organic methods rather than petroleum based machines and fertilizers, there is a huge need for more farmers, up to 10 of the millions of them. Then forestry is also the environmental career in the next decade. Over 1.6 billion people depend on forests for their livelihood. Foresters teach people cultivation of higher value, faster growing species for food, medicine, or timber. For example, while carefully documenting the impact on the environment. Okay. Then, solar power installer. Making and installing solar power systems already accounts for more than around 770,000 jobs globally. The Solar Energy Industries Association predicts a further increase if anticipated tax credits are accelerated. So that also one of the career that is in trend and is going to be in trend for the next decade. And then the green building or the energy efficiency building design and construction. The buildings account for up to 48% of the, if they are talking about the US, that is 48% of the US energy use and greenhouse gas emissions. LEED, jo abhi humne dekha tha. Okay, so it is the major green building certification who has over 43,000 accredited professionals. A study suggests that an around $89.9 billion investment in financing to create 827,260 jobs in US alone. So it's just for the one country. When you talk about it on global level, it has more demand and more of the career opportunities in energy efficiency, building design and construction. Then wind turbine fabricator. Wind is the leading and the fastest growing source of alternative energy with over 3 lakh jobs worldwide. Turbines are 90% metal by weight, creating an opportunity for auto workers and other manufacturers to repurpose their skills. So that is also one of the opportunity when you talk about green technologies. Then conservation biologists. The urgent quest to preserve the integrity of the ecosystem around the world and to quantify the value of the ecosystem services leads to opportunities in teaching, research and field work of government, non-profit and private companies. So conservation biologist is also one of the career options. Then you have sustainability systems developer. The green economy needs specialized software developers and engineers who design, build, and maintain the networks of sensors and modeling that underpin wind farms, smart energy grids, congestion pricing, and other systems, substituting intelligence for natural resources. So everywhere, when you talk about technology, you do require technology which are related to software. Software, sensors, okay, because your every technology is related with that. You have the interdisciplinary system. Then green MBAs and entrepreneurs, that is, concept of the triple bottom line has migrated from the margins to the mainstream to the business world. Job profiles including the market to the lifestyle of health and sustainability segment to serving as a VP, a vice president of sustainability within a large company to green startups. So you could be an entrepreneur in this old field. Then recycling is also one of the environmental careers where new laws and regulations are created, creating a need for specialized companies that can close the loop by recycling and repurposing the e-waste, clothing, plastic bags. Now, recycling is actually used in our country as well to a large extent. Okay, recycling of the construction waste, other materials. In the US alone, there are more than 1 million jobs in the recycling sector. So this we had seen. Now, global trends and corporate initiatives. Environment as formal education program has evolved over the past 4 decades. Okay, so there are high demand skills, that is green construction, efficient manufacturing, agriculture efficiency and innovation. And there are high demand jobs like the environmental engineer, engineering technologist, operations manager and project manager. Then high levels of education will be needed in the high growth areas. Now we have seen various areas, correct, and high levels of education will be needed according to those areas. So here you see percentage of the employees with bachelor degree or higher. Okay, that is number of employees, number of educated employees that will be needed in this particular area. Okay, so this 53, 46, all this percentage is percentage of the employees with a bachelor degree or a higher degree. Okay, so when you talk about the area of carbon and climate change and mitigation, you require around 53% of the employees with a higher educational degree. When you talk about research development, you require 46%. When you talk about eco-preservation, you require 44%. When you talk about environmental communications, you require 40%. Okay, that is the educational awareness and programs related to environmental communication. When you talk about renewable energy, they require around 39%. And all other environmental employment might require about the 37%. Okay. So there are other the same job areas where environmental employers consider internal recruiting to be the most effective recruitment method. Other effective methods include reference cooperative programs, on-campus recruitment, online job banks. So consulting, there are different job, typical job areas are the consulting companies, manufacturing industries and supply chain, research organizations, training and education organizations, environmental non-profit and NGOs. When we are talking about this different areas, no? That is climate change and everything, okay, energy efficiency and everything. So those are actually the career opportunities in this areas, in this job area. The international development agencies and financing institutions. Then you have this corporate initiatives. Innovative companies are using green as a platform for creating value, new product concepts, service strategies and business models that represent disruptive. For some companies where innovation once seemed elusive and ambiguous, environmental responsibility has become a goal around which new ideas are brought to life. Green hat thinking, the type of idea generation and innovation that comes out of a singular focus on reducing one's environmental impact as much as possible. So that is the green hat thinking, which is taken as the initiative in the corporate sector. Then one of the corporate initiative they have given, that is the Dell 2020 Legacy for Good plan. So the Dell company, then it outlines for future of sustainability and corporate responsibility at Dell. It aims to engage 75% of team members in community service by 2020. It uses expertise and technology to help 3 million youth directly ensure that 90% of the waste generated in the Dell operated buildings is diverted from the landfills. Now what happens is all the waste that is generated in the company directly goes to the landfills. That is, it is dumped, correct? So if the Dell company ensures now that 90% of the waste generated, which actually used to go to the landfill, will be diverted from the landfill. Okay, And then, of course, recycle, reuse, or whatever could be done to reduce the waste, that would be done. And the reduce greenhouse gas, it aims to reduce the greenhouse gas emission from facilities and logistic operations by 50% and reduce the energy intensity of its product portfolio by 80%. So this is also one of the corporate initiative that is taken by the company. And there is also one more company, that is Interface Flooring Pioneers. Then also you have the Eco Magnesian company, which also takes the initiative of green technology. It is designed to meet the demand for more energy efficient products and drive sustainable growth. Focuses on the development of renewable energy sources, water purification initiatives, carbon capture and sequestration, that is separation systems, and alternative transportation systems. In 2007, this company has invested about more than $1 billion on cleaner technology R&D, moving the company closer to its goal of investing $1.5 billion annually in eco-magnesium in R&D initiatives by 2010. So this is how even the corporates are now investing into R&D of the cleaner technology, of the greener technology. Then you have this Google Green, so where even the Google is striving or taking initiatives to move towards the green technologies. So they have been the carbon neutral since 2007. Our data centers use 50% less energy than the typical data center. We have made agreements to fund $2 billion in renewable energy products. A business using Gmail decreases its environmental impact by up to 98%. Of course, because everywhere the paperwork is reduced and Gmails are used for every single work. Okay, so it has reduced the environmental impact by 98%. So Google uses 35% of the renewable energy, and this was about the 2013 data. Okay, where 24% of the renewable electricity is purchased directly or produced by the Google. 35% of the total electricity obtained from the renewable sources, and 11% renewable electricity is already on the grid, and the others are the non-renewable electricity neutralized by the carbon offset projects. So that is why it's the green initiatives, and so it says Google Green. There is also one of the initiative taken by one of the company of called as the Alibaba Group, okay, where their environmental groups, like they build the citizen network to overcome or reduce the water pollution. It has launched to drive public participation in environmental protection and assist the government in dealing the pollution. Then further, there are a few of the local examples, okay, where this is an example of China, where engineering consultants and materials specialists focusing on sustainability for the built environment. So key services are the LEED consulting, building simulations, corporate services, that is sustainability planning and market strategies. Indoor environmental health and safety consulting firm focused on advising clients on air and water quality, mold and lead exposure issues, key products and services like the air and water testing, air cleaning products and masks, water treatment product, HVAC design, so that we you see in your own field also, and implementation. So these are few of the the local examples. Then, like we have seen, I have told you in the first lecture itself, like we now move towards the organic thing. So few more eco examples are the healthy cleaning products with no toxic and unnecessary chemicals, but at the same time products are affordable. So home care, personal care, baby care, all those things, and the cosmetics and the fruits and vegetables, all those things that are required in your home, so that are turned into green or the eco-friendly products. So that also become one of the career opportunity or the examples of green technology being used at the local level. This is also about the organic food that we were talking, that is more healthier. We are moving to the more organic, more green foods, right? So these are certain examples of the company. Of course, it's not the company of our country, but there are such countries. There are countries which have the local agency, local companies which are overtaking the, or which are following the green technologies. Future of the environmental workforce, that is the strong global growth across the sector, increased career opportunities in high growth sectors of the industry, work transferability between multiple disciplines, industries and environmental sectors, because people are from different areas coming together. Then continuous learning through an evolving and changing sector, rising employment opportunities as baby boomers retire, and a high level of job satisfaction and job engagement. So green is essentially synonyms with change. When you talk about future of green, green is essentially a synonym to change. When you talk about change, so green is what is going to be followed in terms of how we consume, how we do business, how we work, and how we approach innovation. The beauty of green is that it also synonyms with growth. So green does not just mean the change, it also means the growth. As we move into an era of constrained resources, organizations that help their customers minimize waste and resource consumption will emerge as the market leaders. As an individual, there are countless ways to get there, no matter what role you play in your organization. Oh. So wherever you sit, you have an opportunity to be a leader in the race towards sustainability. The only question is, how fast are you willing to get there? So there are opportunities. When you talk about careers in this environmental sector, in the green technology, there are opportunities. It is only the thing is, how fast you are willing to get there. Okay. So that was all about the different career opportunities in the environmental sector. Wherein you not just being a particular discipline of engineering, the sector is combines people from different disciplines. It's an interdisciplinary sector. Okay, wherein not just the engineers, even the other graduate people will have their own interest in different areas of the environmental sector. Okay.